Massa, ooh, ooh, Massa, ooh, ooh, Massa, ooh, ooh. We have watched from Canadian soil as our homeland has been abused and marketed. They laugh at our clothing, laugh at our accents.
We are the baseline for suffering.
Make sure you finish your food.
There are hungry children in Africa. Remember
the hungry African children.
As if pity can serve as sustenance.
As if our stomach is a wishing well. It is almost Christmas.
And you know what that means?
World Vision commercials. Pity-inducing, gut-wrenching images of African children. Please, remember the hungry African children.
For just $1 a day,
you too can pretend to care, pretend to know. Pretend you are a solution and not the problem. Ibambe, you think we live in mud huts. We think you live on a foundation of lies.
Yes,
we have cars and gelato ice cream. Yes, we have air conditioning.
And Kentucky fried chicken.
Finger licking good. But we also use fork and knife and spoon.
No, I did not go to school on a zebra and I did not have a pet lion.
You wonder about our land.
And you look to your zoos for inspiration.
Which side of the cage do we belong? Ibambe!
Can you believe what he said?
Who?
That American orange.
You mean the one whose hair is held together by a single staple?
That overzealous ostrich.
That flabbergasting flamingo.
The racist rhinoceros.
What did he say now?
So this disingenuous dinosaur, through the wrinkles in his face, found the space to call us a shithole.
Yeah, Charlie! This reminds me of an old African proverb. He who smelt it, dealt it.
Meaning the statement that we are a shithole must first in and of itself come from a hole of shit.
America, is this your king? When we do magic, it is black, it is demonic. When Christopher does magic, he is an angel. Chris Angel can never survive economic collapse, systemic oppression. They've taken our weapons and made them a lesson, neglected and threatened. Customs and costumes, bury me alone in the ocean. Our ancestors jump from the ships. Cause they knew that death was better than bondage and opted for dodging the whips. So our heroes,
Winnie Mandela, Kofi Annan, Marcus Garvey,
your heroes, Spider-Man, Iron Man, the white man,
Stan Lee. We appreciate Black Panther. But why must an advanced motherland be fictional to be believable?
Look at Africa through an American lens. Marvel at our suffering and call it the big picture. But this is not Wakanda, it is Africa.
Which is not a country.
But a coastline that sunsets dream of. There's a rhythm in the roads, the market, the streets.
The sway of the tide. She is Azonto and Shoki in the nighttime.
She's the scent of Jollof in the morning.
She is Mother.
Mother Africa. Africa forever. Africa forever. Or until you lose interest again.